If your ink's too slow and your nib won't flow, here's one of the places that you can go. Larry is here to see you through with Mr. Announcer and Cubby too. It's Larry's Fountain Pen Reviews.
Well, hello everybody. It's been a while, I know it, but this is your main man, Larry, here in Fort Worth, Texas. Thought I'd come on and give you a shout and let you know what's going on here a little bit. First of all, on October the 10th, which is, what, a Sunday, I believe, at 3 p. Central Time, we're going to have Tim Cullen as our Zoom Pen Hangout, our guest on there, so he'll be on. He is a pen maker. So if you don't know of Tim, you need to check him out on Facebook. He does some amazing work on fountain pens. Yes, you're going to see amazing. Yes. So he'll be on, and can't wait to have him. And then a reminder on October the 24th, that's a Sunday at 1 p.m. Central Time. We're going to have, who is it, Mr. Announcer? Mr.?
Vitolo.
No, wrong. Mr. Dante.
Dante Del Vecchio.
Yes, very good.
You didn't tell me to look at the schedule.
I thought you already knew. So anyway, that's who is coming on. Okay? So, and then I'm going to have Doc come on now.
Vitolo?
Yes. Yeah. As soon as I get that spot lined up for him, he'll be coming on. So I've got some stuff going on still. So, forgive me for not being on as much as I used to, but I've been having some ups and downs with the health thing. And I want to leave it at that. Well, I don't even know how to put it in words yet. So maybe I'll just leave it alone for right now until it occurs. Isn't that right, Mr. Announcer? Yes. Then I'll let you know. So what else am I missing here? So this coming Tuesday, I want you to join Tony and myself. We'll be on to 6:30 Central Time. For me. So mark all this on your calendar and you might want to hang out and have some fun with us. We always have a good time, Tony and I. And what else has been going on? I'm still working on the pen pal letters that I've gotten in. So don't give up on me. It just takes me a little time to get there, but I'm going to get there. Right now my left wrist is starting to have some problems. So, of course, the pin shows have opened up. I couldn't make the Dallas pin show. That's a bummer. I knew it. I wanted to go, but couldn't go. We did have our flu shots today, but we couldn't get our booster shots, our Moderna booster shots, because, are you ready for this? Well, we don't have enough underlying health problems. I've got a bunch, and so does Mr. Announcer, and mine are really severe, but not as severe enough to get me on the booster lineup, Mr. Announcer either. People that, cancer, what else, do you remember?
Anything that causes immunodeficiency.
Yeah, so they're on the first round, so, you know, talking to the pharmacist, and he said he doesn't know. I mean, up to the government, because they're the ones that are going to decide who's going to be the ones to get that booster shot. So, so much for that. We were kind of excited to get that done, but now that's not going to happen. As soon as I get the inks in for Robert Oyster inks, I'll be continuing that ink journey. So that's going to be really interesting and a lot of fun. And I really want to give a, a special thank you to Lena from Pen Boutique. Thank you, Lena, for all your support that you've given me and helping me through. I really appreciate you and your staff. And also a special shout out to Frank from Federalist Pens and Paper. You've been there, buddy, for me as well. And I really want to thank you, Frank, for all you have done for me as well. So there's a lot of pen people out there that has really helped me. Anderson Pens, thank you for the Andersons as well. And Tom from Gold Spot Pens, Pen Chalet, just many more of them. So I really want to thank you. People were saying that they're surprised that my subscriber numbers aren't really up there in the numbers. A lot of them say they still cannot find me, but, you know, that's okay. We're small, but we're mighty. You know, I'm cool with that. It doesn't matter if I have 4,000, 5,000, whatever. I'm not into numbers. I'm into people. As long as you're happy, that's cool. You know, I do my own thing here. I don't try to copy anybody. I'm sure other people may have picked up some ways I do things, and that's cool. I have a lot of fun doing it. So again, what do? I do pen reviews. I don't do a lot of vintage. I do like vintage, but only certain types of vintage pen. I don't get into all the vintage, no. I think one of my favorite vintage pens, believe it or not, would be the school Schaefer pen, because, you know, going to school, I grew up with that pen. So that's, to me, really one of my favorites. But then I like is it Estabrook, the Parkers, the Schaefers, I'm sure the Eversharp, and I'm sure I'm forgetting some already. But like I said, I do like some vintage, but not all my vintage. And also, I guess I want to announce and let everybody know that Troy LaPlante, friend of mine in Salem, he's running for city council. So the best to him, and I wish him the best. If anybody should win that position, it should be Troy. I know Troy personally. I know what kind of man he is. I know what kind of heart he is. He's an honest guy. He really is an honest, caring, loving guy. And he tells you like it is. He doesn't salt and pepper it. He's right out there with it. And he'll do the best job that he possibly can. Okay? So, if there's anyone out there that can help straighten out that school system that needs it out there, it's going to be Troy. But it's going to take everybody to give him the support he needs to overcome these obstacles. So, prayers for Troy. Anything else we need to say, Mr. Announcer?
I think that covers it for the upcoming stuff.
Okay, so hey, y'all can do me a favor out there, each and every one of you. Spread the word. Tell the people about Larry's Fountain Pens. Tell them where to come to. Tell them about my Zoom Pen Hangout. That's a lot of fun. It really is. So, folks, I'm going to go ahead and get off now. I got to take some medicine and all that good stuff. Okay? So, God bless each and every one of you. Take care, my friends. Be extra safe. Be kind to a stranger out there, please. And a lot of peace and a lot of love to each and every one of you. You guys are amazing. You guys are the star. Remember that. I'm not the star. You guys are. Okay? I'm here for you. And you guys give me the strength to keep coming back. And I'm going to fight and fight to come back each time. So, my friends, we're done. And as always, don't pick up your phone and text while you're driving. If you want to live, if you want others to live, get out of the habit of doing this. I've seen so many people on the phone texting while driving. I've seen people at the stoplight texting and the light's already green and they're still at the light texting. Okay? And one more thing before I go, road rage, totally out of hand now. we had a young couple. They're driving for what?
One of the eating delivery places.
Ubers or?
No, Grubhub or something like that.
Something like that here in Fort Worth. By our house. And this kind of stuff has never went on because I grew up here in Fort Worth. But things have changed. Times have changed. People have changed. Everything has changed. And he honked the horn so they can move out of the way or go or whatever it was. And what I'm hearing is three people got out of the truck, went over to the car, and shot them dead. They killed the husband, shot him in the head, shot his wife, I believe, in the head or somewhere else, but she's in critical condition right now. And they have a description of the truck, but I don't think the plates, but they're still looking for these low-life criminals. These are the kind of criminals we need off the street, and we need them off now to protect our children, to protect your children, to protect your lives, to keep America safe. God bless. We're done. Later, folks.